Hi YouTube, welcome to part 2 of my RPG mapping in Sketchup series. Today I'm going to show you how to make some simple buildings with walls and roofs. First, lay down a 10-foot square plane and use the offset tool to come in 1 foot on all sides. This box then gets pulled up 7 feet to create the first story walls. Grouping these objects together makes it easier in the next step. Create a second plane on top of the walls group and use the offset to come out 1 foot on all sides to form the base of the roof. Delete the lines of the innermost box and pull the roof base up 5 feet. Use the line tool to draw the roof angle and then push the excess corners along the roof to remove them. This is a very basic roof shape. To define the gable and eaves, draw two lines along the underside of the roof, 1 foot away from its edge, and a third line down from the roof apex. These construction lines will make your life easier later on. Then draw two further lines parallel with the roof to a point below the roof apex to create the gable ends. Push these in 1 foot on each end. When pushing through an object, sometimes you end up with a hole at one end, which will need to be closed. Delete any excess lines at the base of each gable. If the faces of your roof are grey, they will need to be reversed using the Orient Faces Context option. Unhide the walls group and explode everything. Then delete the extra lines to seamlessly join the gables to the walls. Group everything together. Congratulations, you've just created a small square house. The wall construction technique is the same for all buildings in this video. First, we create a base which mirrors the roof outline and offset this inwards by 1 foot to create the roof overhang. This inner core shape is then pulled up 7 feet to create the ground floor walls. After creating our 10-foot square roof plate, we divide this in half and let SketchUp find the midpoint along the line. Then draw a 5-foot high line vertically along the blue axis to mark the apex of the roof. Hiding the walls lets you orbit the object to delete any excess construction lines from the underside. If all your roof faces are grey, then reverse them using the Reverse Faces Context menu option. Larger hip roofs are just as easy to make and follow the same pattern. After creating the roof plate and offsetting by a foot to create our overhang, divide this rectangle into quarters. Join the corners of each end with lines to form triangles. At the apex of these triangles, draw 5 foot high vertical lines to mark the apex and join all the apexes and corners together. Again, if some of your roof faces end up being grey, you can use the Orient Faces context option to reorient them to be white. As in the previous examples, create the basic L-shaped roof outline, offset it, and pull up to create the walls. in our roof plate, hide the walls group. Subdivide the two end boxes to find the midpoint, then create vertical 5-foot-high lines to mark the apexes. Connect the corners of each end to create triangles. Then connect these two triangles together with lines drawn along the green and red axis, using the Shift key to constrain the axis. So to recap, we've created three of the basic roof shapes seen in top-down maps. In the next episode, I'll look at three other typical roof shapes: the cross gable, the gambrel, and the mansard roof. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.